3 verse 20 is, it is finished. Thank you.
before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and without blame before him in love, having predestinated us unto the adoption of children by Jesus Christ to himself, according to the good pleasure of his will, to the praise of the glory of his grace, wherein he hath made us accepted in the beloved, in whom we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins, according to the riches of his grace.
So, 7 says, in whom we have redemption through Jesus' blood, the forgiveness of sins according to his riches and glory. So when Jesus died, he redeemed us to God through his blood. So his blood brought or gave us forgiveness of our sins, of all of our sins, of all of our iniquities, all of them, and made us children of God, having predestinated us unto the adoption of children by Christ Jesus to himself, himself meaning to God. So that should be having predestinated us unto the adoption of children by Christ Jesus to God. So Jesus now, through adoption, made us children of God because of what he did at Calvary. So it was finished. So we became children of the Most High God through the blood of Jesus Christ. So free. Freely we have been purchased by the blood of God, by the blood of Jesus Christ. So when Jesus said it was finished, he's talking about we are no longer under the law of the old covenant, where there was blood sacrifices that have to be given for sins that men did. Jesus came once and for all the acceptable lamb that redeemed us to God, and through his blood forgave all of our sins and all of our iniquities. So us being children of God, we are joint heirs in Christ also. So we should not be living a life of hardship. We should not be living a life of poverty. Because of all that Jesus did. So we've not just been saved just to die the way we are, whether in poverty or depression, not having the needs met. No. When Jesus died, he gave us back everything. It is a bit of covenant that gave us. So we're going to be now what Jesus did, what God did. So we're still in Ephesians. We're going to be from 19 to 21. 19 to 21, ready to read?
And what is the exceeding greatness of his power to us who believe according to the
every chance. That means that Satan has no authority or no power greater than God, Jesus. Because of what Jesus did, he has freedom. God seated him on his right. Let's now read Ephesians 2, verse 6. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 6. Ready, read.
And have raised us up together and made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. And have raised us up together and made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus.
Amen. So now,
and see.
us. We have been raised to be raised.
Yes, we have to die. That means the flesh dies.
Come on. To deliver us.
So we cannot allow our flesh to speak to us and say, I feel sick. I have this and I have that. You have it because you clean it.
That's right.
Because you smoke it. You clean it because you accept it. The doctor said I have cancer. The doctor said that.
Who do you want?
Stand up, Stephen. What happened to Stephen? Right.
Ephesians 1 and 7, in whom we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins through Jesus' blood. So we have been redeemed. And let's go to Galatians. Galatians chapter 2. Reading verses 13 and 14. Galatians chapter 2. Reading verses 13 and 14. Ready to read?
And you, being dead in your sins, and the uncircumcision of your flesh, have been quickened together with him, having forgiven you all trespasses, blotting out the handwriting of ordinances that was against us, which was contrary to us, and took it out of the way, nailing it to his cross.
Let me get to see the manifestation of all the promises of God.
The word of God said God, the word of God said God promises are yes and amen. But we have to know what these promises are. They have been freely given to us, and we just read a part of it, a small piece of it, in Ephesians 3. Blessed is the God of our blessed is the God of God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. A promise. All spiritual blessings.
Right.
Over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth. before Adam sinned. All the animals lived in harmony. You could go and pet a lion or a tiger, or go play with a bear and stop. Try it now. Try it now. Because we lost it. We lost it because of sin. In Christ now, Christ is saying to us, God is saying to us, we have power, we have authority, we have power over all of our time. So here it is now, let's go to Mark.
So whosoever shall say, and Thank you.
because your flesh now don't have the strength to fight. God will never tell us to fight this strength, physical strength. If we want to just fight physical strength, he will never tell us we are seated in Christ. We never move and have our being in God. It's in or out.
Yes.
So it tells us, cannot be about flesh, cannot be about how you feel, what you see with your natural eyes. It's all spiritual. We serve a spiritual God. I am He is a spirit being. So we have to know how to direct our future, control our future by the Word of God that is written for us. So we take authority over every situation. And you speak and say, now this poverty, you can't do anything wrong. Because my Jesus. my parent, the brother and sisters in Christ, and he told me,
God's faith, come on.
mountains how to move. They cannot stand. They have to move. When Jesus was hungry and there was a fig tree, he saw the leaves. When he got close to the fig tree, we have that authority. Satan can't stand up against our life because everything shut down and come to death after Jesus Christ is gone. When Jesus walked on this earth in flesh before he went to the cross, every demon knew who he was. Thou son of God, thou son of David, have you come to destroy us? That's not my time. Who do you know here? Thou son of God, Jesus said, decide it. Why? They knew. They knew who he was, that he truly was the Son of God, and is the Son of God. So we are in that same Son of God. We are in him. Using the authority given to us by him. Not by us, but by his. Because we've been seated with him. So there's no power, no principality, no might, no dominion, no name. Nothing more powerful than Christ. So when you go in your prayer to God and you start declaring, you make sure Holy Spirit, give me the declaration to start to speak, give me a spirit of boldness, Lord authority, so that when I speak, I believe I see what I speak. I speak because you tell me to speak, and you tell me to speak your way. So you have to know how you speak.
Yeah.
because it was already given to you. Jesus purchased it by his blood. Father God, we are obedient to Father Lord, I declare and fill today, for you are our shepherd. And we holding on to your words and giving thanks, Father Lord, for the manifestation of everything that is needed in our lives and the manifest in our name of Jesus. I speak to every fridge, I speak to every cupboard, and I say be filled with the name of Jesus to the things. Father Lord, let it run over, Father Lord, and give you a blessing for the ones that you sent our way or you lay in our hearts, Father Lord, in the name of Jesus. Yes, thank you. Marching on base of grass and country bars of life, us to speak, Father God, in the name of Jesus. And God, I declare.